All right, so let's start. I have not heard of such success in this pandemic than you have provided to us. So, Teresa, tell us a little bit about the MedSpa, where your origin came from, a couple of minutes about how did we get here?
Sure, yeah, interesting story. I'm the child of an African immigrant, so I'm true African American. My parents came to this country from Ethiopia with no money, no skills, and typical rags to riches US success story. Entrepreneurial spirit, not one day a formal education. It's kind of weird because I think formal education would have ruined them and made them too schooled. And so I have that entrepreneurial spirit that I've combined with my medical practice into this very successful cosmetic dermatology practice.
Can you talk to us about what the market is like now in your area?
Yeah, good question. Honestly, Matt, the market is booming. Billionaires are made during recessions, right? From Warren Buffett to Sam Walton, who started Walmart during the Great Recession. Patients want work done now while they're home with recovery time. And so procedures that involve some recovery time are the things you need to market and get out there now. So a couple examples of that are lip fillers, lasers, and Kybella. So lip fillers, for example, I've coined the term and invented the word mini syringe of lip filler. The mini syringe is just a half a syringe of filler mixed with some lidocaine with epinephrine. All these women who have always wanted their lips injected and were too scared to go to work the next day looking like Daffy Duck. All these people who are scared of the downtime want to come in and have this done while they're sitting at home. Sell your laser packages now. Sell them in packages of three, once a month for 3 months in a row, and you'll be done, sister, by the time the world opens up again. Let's get your laser done now. Each time, you're going to look like you're sunburned for 3 to 5 days. And she loves that. She's going to be home anyway. She says, I'm going to turn the camera off on my Zoom meetings from my banker job or my teacher job, whatever it is, and get it done now. Kybella is a lucrative injectable. It gets rid of the chin fat. People want that done now so they don't have to go to work looking like a bullfrog for the next few days. So the word would be take advantage of these times now, or somebody else is going to do that for you.
Thank you for the descriptive technology. I think you made a point, which is that the market hasn't disappeared. And we've been trying to tell a lot of the practitioners out there to understand that patients never left. It's not like they're on some continent somewhere that they are, you know, gone. Yeah. They have the same requirements, the same wants, the same needs. You just have to think a little bit differently or deliver a little differently, depending on where you are in the country, right? And every state has a different way of thinking about their opening up stage. And some aren't, you know, going to open up for a while. So there's some variables in there. But has there been any impact on the consumer mentality? Have you had to do anything specific in the practice?
Yeah, so there's a few things we're doing differently right now. We're wearing our masks when we inject a patient, obviously. Before that, I wasn't wearing a mask. But other things that we're doing differently now, for example, to bring the new patients in, offer them your rock bottom pricing. Figure out what your rock bottom is and offer them that. To medical providers, something that I always do differently, and my word to them would be, get the heck out of your comfort zone. Forget about the textbooks. Forget about third-party payers right now. Tell her, I'm sorry if I'm using female pronouns, but most of my patients are female. Tell her what she needs and tell her why. Like the iconic Steve Jobs said, he tells people what they need and he gives it to them. Nobody ever thought they needed an iPhone before he came around, but now everybody does, right? Not in a pushy, annoying way, but in a loving, caring way without bothering them. So an example of that would be like for the stuff that gets rid of the chin fat. Ask her, does that bother you, Jennifer? Of course it does. Well, then take her phone from her lap, go around to the side of her and take a photograph of that piece of her body, of that little double chin there. And she's mortified because she hates that. She never actually looked at it from the profile. And then you say to her, would you be open to getting rid of that or to minimizing that right now? Heck yeah, she would be. And she's thrilled about it. And then you say, and that's going to give the illusion of your whole body being sculpted. And then you sold her on this feeling as well. So you want to talk to her about that as well. And then another different thing that we're doing more of now is asking for that referral and become their friend, wow them with your business, and then ask for that referral. Because otherwise, honestly, Matt, they're not giving the referral to their cosmetic dermatologist. And I make the babysitter to Botox analogy here. You know, if she finds a great babysitter or a great hairdresser, she's going to tell 10 people. If she finds a great Botox doctor, she's not going to tell anyone. And so
I got you. I think those are just such valid points. I mean, very, very, very true. You had mentioned you're doing great. And a lot of people would say, how in the world are you doing record amounts of, so what's working for you? I mean, you mentioned a couple of things right there. We've been helping you with ads and getting, you know, the profit engine set up, and all that stuff's sort of part of it. Is there anything special sauce that you think is really driving a record month for you today?
As far as today alone, probably so. And of course, teaming up with you guys just a few months ago has aided that record at more than anything. But something that has always worked for me that I think any provider needs to add is, and it's so cliche, but just write down your goals. Write down your goals, put your little vision board up where you're going to see it and forced to look at it every single day. Mine is in my bathroom cabinet. I got to look at it when I pick up my toothbrush, and make it as specific as possible, written in the present tense with the way it makes you feel. So something like, today I feel happy and blessed and my business is making 30K or 50K or whatever you want it to be this week. And I'm spending time with family and friends. So something on a special sauce there that I think every entrepreneur needs to add. And then the second piece of that would be kind of based on our slogan. And our slogan is, quote, look and feel your 100%. We're selling a feeling, not a look, right? We're not going to make her look leave my office looking like she's 25 again. People buy based on emotion. They don't buy anything based on the facts. They're buying based on their feelings. And so your job is to make her feel like she's 100%. So that's where the provider needs to move.
That's great. So let's get one small example, and then let's get into some of the sales dialogue, because we really want to kind of concentrate on good things that we could help out other people with, trying to get some of the experience and your expertise. But I wanted to say, what's a typical week look like for you now?
Interesting question that I probably wasn't prepared to answer, but to be honest, my schedule is not completely booked at the beginning of the week, but you guys get it filled by 72 hours before this day. I'm injecting patients and working from 9:30 to 4 on Wednesdays. It's my late day today, so maybe until 7 p.m. Otherwise, I'm not working past that. We're treating about 20 patients a day. We're spacing them out as much as we can. So we're spacing them out every 30 minutes or so. So there's never two patients in the room around each other at the same time. If another person shows up and there's one in the waiting room, she politely waits on the patio or out in her car.
Sure.
People are stoked to be getting in. They're coming in their sweats, or they're coming in dressed up saying, I'm so excited to get dressed up and be in your office today. I haven't been out in 6 weeks. Yeah. And so
that's what I was asking, like what the visuals like, because I think a lot of people are stuck, you know, and it was an off the cuff question I wanted to ask you, because a lot of people are just like, well, what happens when you go back? Because a lot of people are just going to start to go back to normal across the country.
Uh-huh.
You're sort of already there and you've sort of gotten through it. And that's why I wanted to ask, so that people can understand the business will come back. Don't be afraid. You know,
she's been living her life, going from her daytime pajamas to her nighttime pajamas, and she's excited to get out of the house. And you need to capitalize on that now. But like I said, somebody else will.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's a good segue. So let's delve into the sales stuff. So I also agree with you 100% that this business, especially in the med spa, aesthetics, plastic surgery, all the stuff that is cash paid, it's a positive. You know, a lot of medicals that we deal with are different because it's more pain relief. This is more, you know, a positive experience for them. So let's talk about your sales strategy, and then we'll wrap it up from there. So talk to me a little bit about what you think is the good thing that you could, you know, leave off with someone who's watching this to say, wow, that's a great, you know, theory around how to get better strategy around my sales and to get patients to be super excited to refer.
Awesome. Yeah. So kind of some simple sales tips 101 for physicians who know nothing about this. There's some very specific body language and wording that I very intentionally use that I like to share with other providers. When you walk into the room, even to do it, if it's a follow-up appointment, if somebody's seen 100 times, have your white coat on. It gives you credibility. Walk in that room, shoulders back, chin high, huge smile with big white teeth. You need to work on your grooming. Big white teeth, huge smile. Act like you're stoked to make her feel good today, even if you're not, right? Act happy anyway. You've heard, if you want to be happy, act like you're happy and the emotions will follow. So act like you're stoked today to make her feel good. You should be thrilled to be there today and act that way. Big smile, use her name in the middle of a sentence, not in the beginning or the end of the sentence. Your name in the middle of the sentence. People love hearing their name, especially in the middle of a sentence there. Excellent eye contact, of course. Then, all right, Jamie, let's get to know your face again. Hold this mirror here, hand to the mirror, in your left hand. In my office, it's the left hand because most of the good lighting is on the right side. And then you ask her this. Give yourself a big hello smile. Bigger, no, even bigger, big open mouth smile. Now all of her wrinkles really come out, right? So you got her smiling at herself. And then you say something like, tell me, Jennifer, tell me everything that bugs you about this. Tell me everything that's bothering you. And then she'll suddenly, big sigh. And then you've kind of got diarrhea of the mouth, and she's going to go on and on and on about everything that bugs her, and let her talk. Just let her talk until she stops. And just listen and nod. And listen to everything she's saying. And then you're going to be able to upsell her on things that she didn't even mention to you. And there's some specific words you want to use there. The first one is, are you open to dot, dot, dot? Everybody wants to feel open-minded, right? Everyone wants to think that they're open-minded. If you put 100 people in a room and said, who here is open-minded? 100 people are going to raise their hands, right? Everybody wants to consider themselves open-minded. So don't say, hey, do you want to work on this area also? You say, hey, are you open to softening these lines here, softening, not getting rid of them, because then you get the objection of, I don't want to be able to move my face. I don't want to look 25. I'm 50. I need to look 50. Of course, I want you to leave today, Melissa, looking like your best 50. Are you open to softening these lines here? So another one that I want you to work on, another phrase that I want you to work on using with your patients is, this will make you feel dot, dot, dot. So you want her to feel lifted, healthy, sculpted. It doesn't matter what she looks like. People are buying a feeling. They're buying on emotion, especially right now, more than ever. And so this will make you feel lifted, healthy, and sculpted. Let's work on this. And then she's excited about it. And then the last little phrase I want you to use is, especially when they're going to ask, how does it work or what will it do? You don't really have to answer that question. Again, to quote the iconic Steve Jobs, when he was asked on a stage, how does the iPod really work? He said, it puts 1,000 songs in your pocket. You all know how he answered that, right? And so you tell them the benefits. Tell them the feeling. Say, this will make you feel sculpted, lifted, and healthy. And if she wants the science, she'll ask about it. But that's not what she's here for. She's here for a feeling. So a couple other little sales tips. One of them you guys have taken off the ground for me that we honestly weren't able to do before. Get your review request via an SMS text. Don't send them an email request. Everyone gets bombarded, right? Everyone's inbox is full of 1,000 review requests from everything you bought on Amazon over the previous month. If she's leaving and she's stoked and she just made appointments for three other services, you send her that request as she's walking out the door. She's going to see it when she sits down in the car and give you the best review. So you guys were able to get that off the ground for me, and that's helped quite a bit. A couple other points I want to make about kind of sales 101 there. As a provider, I get contacted personally to my own Facebook, my own phone, my own email about people I know socially who want a treatment, right? Don't overtell them, call the office to make an appointment, especially if your practice is new. Now, if you're bombarded and you have too many patients, that's an okay response. But even if you don't know your schedule, say, that's awesome, Linda. I'm so stoked. I'm so excited to help you, not see you. I'm so excited to help you. Can you come today at 3 or tomorrow at 4? Or, third option, tell me what works for you and I'll do my best to make it work. So you give her the two options and then tell me what works best for you. She will always choose one of those two options. She won't put in a third option because she knows your provider and your schedule is swamped. And then you got the appointment made. Done. I just forward that email right over to my receptionist, to my assistant, and the appointment's made. I don't have to tell her to call or worry if she's going to call. Done. And use those words and finish the email, finish the text with, I'm so looking forward to helping you. Exclamation point, smiley face. Now she knows she's not getting answered by a bot or a machine. So be personal there. Last point on that kind of sales 101, so cliche. Please tell me everybody knows this. Make your follow-up appointments before the patient leaves, while they're there in the reception area. Everybody knows this. Couple of objections to overcome there. You know what? I'm a nurse and I work shifts and I don't know my schedule yet, so I'll call you. You know what, Melissa? Our schedule, you know, that would put us into July. So for your 3 month follow up, and that's one of our busiest months of the year. It doesn't matter what month it is. I don't care. That's one of our busiest months of the year. So let's get you on the schedule now. We can always tweak the time if we have to, but this way you're on the schedule. So we don't have to worry about it. It's always easier to change your time than to get you on the schedule. So now you've got her on the schedule. She's going to realize in 3 months from now, her tox is wearing off and she's going to be excited to do what she has to do, get a babysitter to keep that appointment that she wouldn't have made otherwise. So those are my sales tips, some specific body language, specific words. Use them. They work great for me. If you have anything that works great for you, we want to know about it too.
Teresa, I couldn't thank you more. That was just awesome. I mean, those tips are gold. And I hope that's anybody great. Listening to this understands that. Teresa, how do people get in contact with you if they want to connect with you or they want to just have a conversation about things that's on their mind that they could get engaged with? Or even better, your social profiles or anything you want to say that's, you know, direct to, you know, helping people connect with you.
So yes, please check out our awesome website that Practice Bloom is doing such a great job on, newmedicalspausa.com, newmedicalspausa.com. If you hit contact me, it comes directly to my inbox, or contact me on Instagram at tcamdenmd, T as in Teresa, at tcamdenmd. Yeah.
Terrific. Thank you so much. I appreciate the time, and I can't wait to do a follow-up. I want to try and do one about 6 months from now to show where you are from where we are today. And I guarantee after this is all blown over, I think everybody's going to be in the upswing even more from where you are, which would be amazing.
I'm looking forward to that, Matt. Yes, sir.